Welcome to Brand Insider. In this video, we are going to talk about Apple M1 vs M1 Pro vs M1 Max. The new MacBook Pro is an advancement of the year-old Apple Silicon, which gives the new models better computing power and graphical capability. Here's how the M1 Pro and M1 Max stack up against the original, as well as what it means for the Mac portfolio. Apple's switch away from Intel CPUs was marked by the release of new Mac models employing M1 chips, including the 13-inch MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, and Mac Mini. The announcement, which kicked off a two-year plan for Apple to transition its entire Mac product line, was a huge success, with Apple's new chip outperforming the competition. Apple introduced the M1 Pro and M1 Max as the mid-range and premium options for its MacBook laptop lineup in fall 2021, bringing the total number of Apple Silicon chip options to 3. While not a full second-generation release like an iPhone upgrade from the A14 to the A15, the upgrade is more akin to earlier A-series updates designed particularly for the iPad Pro lineup, such as the A12Z Bionic. Apple took the lessons learned from the M1 and expanded on them to develop better variations. The M1 Pro and M1 Max offer significant upgrades over the original M1, making Max powered by the CPUs more appealing to professionals and creatives. This is what has changed between Apple's first M1 release and the next wave of CPUs. M1 vs M1 Pro vs M1 Max, construction. Apple's system on chips, SoC, are made by TSMC, Apple's longtime foundry partner and provider of A-series chips. They're all made using a 5-nanometer technology, which has various advantages. This includes shrinking the chip die's physical size, which lowers the cost per chip for wafers and, in turn, the processor's price. In comparison to other techniques, such as the 10-nanometer level used by Intel in its 2021 CPUs, the smaller size allows for lower power consumption and potentially higher overall performance. A smaller die has two advantages. It can generate a more complicated chip in a smaller footprint, and it can also manufacture a more complex chip in a smaller footprint. Apple announced the M1 with 16 billion transistors, slightly more than the A15 Bionic chip's 15.8 billion. Apple opted to take advantage of the size advantages and dream bigger for the new CPUs. The M1 Pro has 33.7 billion transistors, which is more than twice as much as the M1. The M1 Max contains 57 billion transistors, which is a 70% increase over the M1 Pro, which also has 3.5 times the transistors. Because a transistor can be employed in a variety of ways in a chip design, the number of transistors used in a chip does not directly correlate to performance. For example, we know that the CPU components of the M1 Pro and M1 Max are very comparable, but the GPU core counts, among other things, differ dramatically. Specs. The M1, M1 Pro, and M1 Max all have the same fundamental architecture, however, the latter two have significantly more power. They're all SoCs, or system-on-a-chips, which combine the CPU, GPU, and RAM into a single device. As a result, overall efficiency improves, as does the latency between the RAM and the CPU. They're all based on TSMC's N5 node, which is the company's smallest production process at the moment. They blend high-performance Firestorm cores and high-efficiency iStorm cores into a single CPU core. The balance of these two cores is the fundamental distinction between them. The M1 has a total of 8 cores, 4 of which are Firestorm and 4 of which are iStorm. The M1 Pro and Max increase the number of cores to 10, but they have a lot more Firestorm cores. They have 8 Firestorm cores and 2 iStorm cores, resulting in a far more powerful processor overall. Another significant distinction is in the graphics. The M1 has 8 graphics cores, whereas the M1 Pro has up to 16 graphics cores, and the M1 Max has a whopping 32 graphics cores. That's a significant improvement, offering the latest MacBook Pros much-needed legs for GPU-intensive work like 3D modeling and rendering, as well as a gaming boost. The M1 Max also has a lot more RAM. The M1 can only support 16 GB of memory, however, the M1 Max can support up to 64 GB. The M1 Pro tops out at 32 GB. That's not the same as 64 GB of RAM found in a conventional PC, though. The M1 Max, like the M1, uses unified memory, which provides the CPU and GPU access to a single pool of memory depending on the job at hand. Instead of carving out separate bits for each part of the chip, this offers enhanced CPU and GPU performance with greater memory. Performance. Despite fitting within tablets and fanless computers, Apple's M1 processor is extremely powerful. Based on our testing, the M1 destroys Intel's most recent Tiger Lake CPUs despite using only 10 watts. In Geekbench 5, the chip outperformed an Intel CPU by 8% in single-core performance, although consuming nearly 3 times the amount of power. Nonetheless, the M1 Pro and Max provide a significant performance boost. Despite having only 2 additional cores, these new chips have more than double the number of transistors as M1. According to Apple, this leads to a CPU that is up to 70% quicker overall, while the GPU performance on the M1 Pro is about 2 times that of the M1. Apple's assertions are also backed up by leaked benchmarks. In Geekbench, the M1 Max outperformed the M1 by roughly 56% in multi-core performance. Keep in mind that the M1 Max and M1 Pro share the same CPU, so you can expect equal performance from both. Memory and graphics are where the differences lie. The M1 Pro effectively doubles all of the M1's measurements. It has twice the memory bandwidth, 200 GBPS, twice the GPU horsepower, and twice the transistors as the previous model. With 4 times the GPU speed and memory bandwidth of the original M1, the M1 Max is twice the M1 Pro's transistor count. The GPU appears to be the most important factor. GFX Bench benchmarks put the M1 Max's GPU on par with an RTX 3080 mobile or RX 6800 graphics card, even though the chips aren't currently available. The M1 Max was claimed by Apple to be able to match the most powerful laptop GPUs while using a fraction of the power, and these results back up that claim. Before drawing any judgments about performance, we recommend waiting for independent testing. The M1 Max and M1 Pro, on the other hand, appear to be a significant boost over the original M1, with enough graphical power to make even the most powerful laptop graphics card sweat. Battery life. The M1's amazing battery life is one of the reasons it's so great. We got 16 hours of battery life out of the M1 MacBook Pro 13, and 15.5 hours out of the MacBook Air. That's impressive, but Apple claims that the M1 Pro and M1 Max are even better. According to Apple, the 14-inch MacBook Pro with the M1 Pro CPU can play video for up to 17 hours, which is 7 hours longer than the previous MacBook Pro. In addition, the new machines offer quick charging, which allows you to reach 50% battery life in just 30 minutes. However, it's worth being skeptical of Apple's statements in this case. The M1 Pro and M1 Max have much more cores and memory. Simply put, they're more powerful chips that will consume more electricity. We won't be able to evaluate the battery life of these CPUs until we get our hands on the new MacBook Pros, but we expect the base M1 to remain the battery life king. Ports. Because the M1 is a chip that only contains what it needs, Apple has to make certain compromises. Ports are an excellent example of this. Because the M1 only has enough bandwidth for 2 Thunderbolt 3 ports, a dongle or adapter for additional ports is nearly a must-have item. With the M1 Pro and M1 Max, however, this is not the case. There are more Thunderbolt ports on these CPUs, including 4 on the MacBook Pro. This means you can connect up to 4 external monitors, which is more than the M1 MacBook enables. So that's it for today. What do you think of our video? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and would like to hear more from us, please subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications before you go. Thank you so much for watching us.